So we are at the Bouverie Preserve, which is a 535-acre nature preserve that's owned and operated by Audubon Canyon Ranch, which is our parent organization, which has land in Sonoma and Marin County, and also conservation science and education programs for kids.
So I study the role of fire basically on our California ecosystems. I've focused primarily in my research on Northern California, and in fact I've focused primarily on the role of prescribed fire in our ecosystems. Prescribed burning has been a part of these landscapes for thousands of years. All of our plants are adapted to fire in one way or another, and yet for the last 100 years or more we've been suppressing fire. Which has resulted in unnatural fuel loads on the landscape.
This preserve was donated to Audubon Canyon Ranch by David Bouverie, who originally owned the land in, I think, 1974.
Before your American settlers showed up here, the North Bay area had a really high population of Native American tribes, really incredibly high populations in this area. And those tribal groups used fire as one of their primary tools for managing the landscape.
It's very difficult for us. The buildings that did burn, all of them I would say, were designed by David Bouverie. He was an architect.
They'd burned acquired straighter sticks for basket weaving that were more pliable. If you don't burn hazelnut, if you don't burn bear grass, if you don't burn willow, they all get very brittle and you can't use them anymore. If you don't burn in the understory of oak woodlands, acorns are no longer able to germinate, and they're no longer actually edible either because we have this native pest called the acorn weevil. And then your American settlers came in and we were afraid of fire and started suppressing it. And we entered this era of fire suppression during which all of these landscapes that need fire and have for always, essentially, suddenly no longer had fire. It's like the fire is essentially cleaning the forest. It clears out all of that dead debris, cleans it up, makes more open stands. It actually helps the larger trees thrive because they don't have to compete with all of this dead debris and all these new young trees encroaching in the open space. It makes water more available for the large trees, and it allows them to be less stressed. And it makes it harder for pathogens to pass among tree to tree because there's more space in between them.
It wouldn't have burned this bad.
The answer is creating a culture that appreciates and values and respects the fact that fire is a part of our landscapes. If we can become a culture that is aware of fire's role in our lands, then that can shift everything. We can build homes that are more fire resilient. We can maintain our homes in a more fire resilient way. We can place our homes in locations that are wiser in the face of fire and knowing that fire is going to happen at some point. And then we can maintain our landscapes with the acknowledgement that our ecosystems depend on fire to thrive and to be healthy and in balance and to keep fire behavior in check in a way that benefits us in the long run. So back on May 31st of this year, we did 3 controlled burns on this property in grassland, primarily some oak savanna as well. And this is one of the 3 burns. So this is a 13-acre area that we burned. We had firefighters from all different local fire departments and CAL FIRE and National Park Service all here working together to accomplish the burns. So you can see on this side of the trail, there's still grass, it's unburned, unburned leaves, unburned grass, trees, and then on this side of the trail is where wildfire came through and did not reignite this side where we had the controlled burn. And we saw that on all 3 of our burns from this past May, that none of them reignited. And so they were effective barriers for fire movement, and if we had these on a larger scale and use them more broadly throughout the region, we might have had more opportunities for addressing the wildfires as they were happening.